Hey, everybody, you're listening to the PBR podcast. This is Dennis, the intern. I'm down in the studio, up from the well with Derek and Mike. And here we go.
What's up, everybody? PBR Podcast, Mike Blount, Derek D.
Hey, Dennis!
The intern. Hey. We got Taylor Allen's in the house. What up, dude?
Hey.
Looking mighty, mighty Amish.
Hey.
Farming Taylor here.
I'm from Farmingdale.
Yeah.
Ooh, You look like it.
Hello there, good folk. This is Hezekiah Taylor here.
Yeah. Right at the top, let me just say, I forgot, shout out to Celeste, who made those statues for us.
Oh, they would be great right on the
I forgot
shelf.
To bring Mike.
Oh, my God.
Mike and Dennis, the interns. Statue, they're in my room, and I forgot to bring them.
Statue.
Sorry,
Funko Pops.
Yeah, we posted them obviously on social media and stuff. But just shout out to Celeste, thank you very much, Mike, Dennis. I'll bring them next time.
Thank you,
and you can just bring mine whenever.
Taylor, there's not one of you.
There is one. We're gonna make one of those corn husk dolls.
I heard there's one of Steve Arena. Steve Arena.
Steve Arena.
Steve Arena. How's Steve?
He's good.
I mean, let's just shout it out. Like, if you're not listening to Taylor Allen's podcast.
Calling the shots.
Calling the shots.
Calling the shots.
You're doing it right, man.
Get on it.
You're not doing it right.
You're not podcasting.
We've been doing a lot of remote feeds lately because we haven't been able to get together.
Speaking of, didn't you just have your 50th not that long ago?
We did.
And speaking of, didn't some people like throw in like they recorded something for you for the 50th? I mean, I did. Did anyone else here do that for you?
No.
Who did?
Wow, we are what? Not even a minute into this thing, and Derek's already made it.
I mean, I can tell you why I didn't do it. I mean, I was working.
Oh yeah,
Derek doesn't work.
Oh yeah,
you know
he's
what I mean.
He's got time.
I was doing a shoot with the Rangers, and I.
No, you
I
weren't. This was well before
thing.
That.
No, I don't
this
think
was well before that.
And then Mike did get in contact with
and
me.
And it took
after,
me two
he's
minutes.
Like, he's like, listen. I forgot to make you a thing, and I'm like, no, it's okay. I was like, I still didn't edit it yet. He's like, all right, cool. I'll make you a thing. And then that was it. Never did.
Where was I, though, man?
I think
was somewhere.
Working.
I was working.
I think you're like, working.
Well, it was a pleasure to be asked.
So Derek, literally took 2 minutes.
There's this thing that happens in the world, right? So like people call you and say, hey, man, are you available to work? And you go, yeah. And then you go,
yeah,
work.
I say yes every time people do that. And I actually was working on something in the middle of it. I just recorded it sitting at my desk really fast and sent it to Taylor.
You couldn't tell.
Yeah, Derek, you're a pretty man. You ever think about me going for like lady shavers, you know, doing those weird,
Yeah, what about like so the back roomer, the back roomer thing?
Yeah.
What was that
Come
called?
Come on, man.
Whatever.
The Manzini?
The Manzini.
Oh, like the infomercials?
Yeah.
I've been on infomercials. I've
like
done
you've been like the guy, like the host of the infomercial?
No, I've been like the guy on the mattress, like, oh, my back in black and white. And then like,
remember when putting on your shoes was like this and the guy like literally blows up his house.
I did another one
now with Lacey Pro.
I did another one. I did a mattress one, and I did one where it was basically this belt they put on you that you just sweat and it melts off.
Right.
But what they did, it was so ridiculous. They put towels around my midsection and wrapped me in saran wrap to make it look like I had a gut, like a spare tire.
Uh-huh.
And then they had me like slump over. Then the next picture, they took that off, put a tight shirt on me and had me like flex as hard as possible.
Oh, we're all getting behind the curtain.
Yeah.
Look behind
how
the
ridiculous
curtain.
Is that?
I mean, those things aren't real?
Yeah.
Remember when sleeping on a mattress was like this and they showed the Johnny Depp from
from
Nightmare on Elm Street just blowing up. And now with Mattress Pro.
Yeah. Most of those are shot in right on Route 46 at this studio in New Jersey.
Really?
Yeah, Sarah Summers.
Suzanne Summers.
She shoots there.
Step by step.
Is she still the thigh master?
When she was.
She was the thigh master. Is there anyone who's taken her place? Does she have to battle to keep the title?
The calf master is now the...
Do you know that... I think we've talked about this, but do you know that Hulk Hogan...
Yes.
...turned down... The George Foreman grill.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It was originally supposed to be the Hulk Hogan grill.
That's what's keeping George in business.
Hell yeah, man. He's set. You don't have to do anything. And now
George Foreman grill.
Well, Hogan's all right.
I'm going to knock out the fat. And
is he?
Huh? What?
Is he all right now?
I mean, is he all right?
He's named all his kids George, so he doesn't have to worry about getting punchy.
I think you're talking about Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
I think he's all right in the sense of money.
That's what I'm wondering.
I don't think he is.
Okay? That's what I'm wondering.
Isn't he in real estate or am I thinking Vanilla Ice?
I mean, I know we haven't been down here in a while, but
he won Gawker.
Everybody's just talking over everybody. What's going on, man?
That's what we wanted. That's what they want.
Can we just have a conversation?
Moment of silence.
Dennis, I'll fuck off.
Issue number one.
Who let him out of the well, dude?
You did. He was here when I got
let him out of the well, dude.
You did. He was here when I got here.
I'm putting in an escalator. No permits.
Before you guys got here, I'm a little bit in a bad mood.
What? Yeah.
First of all, it's 2018, and shit's not. 2018 sucks.
So far.
2018 sucks so far. The end of 2017 sucks.
Positivity.
I almost PBR just burned podcast. My house down like 5 minutes
today?
Ago. And almost died.
Is your wife home?
No.
Oh, that's why. See, you need to be constantly monitored.
I need to be watched around fire, all the time. Right.
Yeah. There's going to be a little one running around soon.
All Mike, I was trying to do.
Mike got himself into a classic like TGI Friday or TGIF from the 90s sitcom husband moment. What did you
do? What'd you do?
Remember when drilling your home was like this?
I can't tell you because Dennis was
I'll stop.
Yeah.
It's impossible for me to tell you what happened. Dennis, just tell
me. All right. No. All right. So here's what happened here. I'll be Mike. I want to drill like a wall. No, go ahead.
I'm trying to be responsible. I'm having a baby, so I was moving stuff around. We ordered new furniture. I got I'm getting ready for that to be delivered. I wanted to move the cable box. So I'm dropping the cable box into the basement because my TV hangs over the fireplace. So you can't get the cable line without opening the walls
right
to the TV. So instead, I'm going to just put the box in the basement and put an IR. It's easier to do it that way. I don't have to do any construction. Well, I didn't have to do any construction.
The original plan
was
for no construction.
No construction.
So basically what you're trying to do is get rid of like the box and any wires that
I got rid of the basement. the whole table that used to be there. There's going to be a chair there.
So it's going
to
be hidden in the basement.
Not for nothing, but 2020 did a whole, you know, thing about how the cable box is a death trap when it comes to babies.
Well, that's why I'm moving
So you got to move it.
So easy, right? Yeah. I just extend the HDMI wire. I bring the cable line into the basement. I
right
bring
up
the IR.
Oh, no. Okay.
Okay. So
the IR is the infrared wire that goes from the cable box to the TV.
Correct.
For people IR stands for infrared.
It actually doesn't go to the TV. It goes just to the cable box.
Right, cable box.
Okay, so, well, when I come down to the basement to look, I see that the cable line is in a hole that's about the size of a cable. Cable. Not very big.
No.
I have to get an HDMI wire down through it, but I also notice that there is an electrical wire
next to it.
In the hole with it.
For your house.
For my house.
For like at a house.
You know, like they pretty much control the TV and the outlets. Yeah, the whole upstairs, right. The whole living room.
Electricity.
So I needed to drill a bigger hole. Yeah. Can you see where this is going?
Yeah. No, but take us on the journey anyway.
I don't know how I didn't get electrocuted and die.
You drilled through the electric
wire. I drilled right through the electric wire.
No, but wasn't it your second effort?
What do you mean?
Because your drill... Wasn't strong enough.
My drill wouldn't work, so
it was in a short.
They shorted it out.
I mean, I don't know. Like, I don't know. Maybe I'm dead. Am I? Are we really here?
I don't know.
There wasn't a spark.
Am I in
no
your heaven?
Pop?
I
no,
did shave clean yesterday. So,
I mean, the circuit didn't break. Like, how am I alive?
Well, that could have been
dumb luck.
Maybe it was an old wire. That's
no,
not,
it is not. The
fortune favors the foolish.
Oh, the power is out of town.
Oh yeah. So
yes, it's out.
You don't have a tripped breaker.
No.
And obviously, you've informed
have
the lovely
talent.
Have you
messed with all your breakers?
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. Well, Dennis was talking over you.
Well, after we're done, we'll check it out. I'll check it out. We'll check it out. There's I mean, you got to
do you
mess
know
with
electric
all your, a little bit. Yeah,
yeah, he knows a little bit.
Why am I alive?
That I don't know. That's divine intervention.
That's a theological.
No, seriously,
question.
Like I did. It was a
you
inch.
Should be dead. I'm being serious. I don't know.
It was an inch thick, like square bit. You know what I mean? Like
yeah, right.
And it wrapped and in and it popped right through.
Was there a rubber handle on the drill or something?
It could be. I mean, you want to grab the drill?
I'll go grab the drill.
I accidentally cut a wire once
with
a scissor.
I'll be right back.
I
gotta go grab the drill.
At least we can talk.
Actually, to the bottom of this.
I cut a wire, like an extension wire once with a scissor, and I got a good like buzz.
First of all, why'd you do that?
I don't know. It was by accident, right. Like Mike did. And I got like a zzz, and I was like, oh, am I, what happened? Like I got so scared, but
that's
I was all right.
But that's only, I mean, you could have, it might have just been a clean cut. It's out though, your power's out.
In that, yeah, it's out to that area.
Hmm.
All right, so here's the drill.
This is scary because
So now, listen, I don't have shoes.
On there. All right, Dennis.
All right, so is it rubber? I guess it's rubber.
It's a good drill. It's a
well,
great
I borrowed
drill.
It from
nice
the electrician
drill.
Across the street, ironically enough.
Well, first of all, call the electrician. That's it.
Well, I did. He came over and he's
he's like, you should be
head.
Dead.
Yeah, he's like, you should be dead. So I'm standing.
Wait.
Now we have a drill on the table.
Why did we bring the drill?
Yeah, because you asked if it had a plastic handle.
Okay. I didn't ask that.
Well, you didn't?
I want to post that and then say, you'll figure out what this is later.
Oh, man.
So I'm standing on a milk carton in my socks. Right. All right.
You should have been standing in a puddle of water. That would
have
helped.
Isn't that, that's recommended by
most
of your
Do you think that's why I'm alive?
I think so.
Maybe, but...
But there wasn't even a spark.
No, the handle would save you. But it would pop. You would have heard something, I feel
like. I didn't
like.
Hear anything. Do you think my TV's ruined?
I think maybe you
no.
cut your line.
No.
And there's still live electric going somewhere in your wall, and that's not good.
Your TV is also a surge protector.
The electrician came over and looked at it.
Oh, so, okay.
I mean, he didn't seem too concerned, right, Dennis?
He did not seem very concerned.
Is he going to run some new stuff?
He's going to run some new stuff tonight.
Yeah.
You guys don't smell anything burning, dude.
No, it might just be your insulation.
Just these hot mics.
Hot mic. I mean, I was electrocuted once. My English muffin got stuck in the toaster.
You put a fork in it, didn't you?
I put a butter knife in it, but I was also 10.
Yeah, but you know now
that shit hurt.
It does not feel good.
Oh, but no, I was electrocuted twice too, but go ahead.
Those like toaster ovens that have like the bars at the top that just get real red. Mm-hmm. But you could touch that with
No, you can't.
The new ones you can't.
No, you can't.
I don't know.
God, you want to test it? Dennis, go get the
toaster. I accidentally touched it the other day when I was getting cheese that was scraped on the bottom.
You got lucky. Crannies. You got lucky like me. We're unelectrocutable.
That's what's up.
You guys are.
Oh my God. Are we?
You've just proven invincibility.
Well, not invincible.
We're electric.
Unelectrocutable.
Okay.
Unelectrocutable, man.
I mean, listen, until one of us gets electrocuted, prove me otherwise.
Never trust.
It's Insulator and the Grounding Man.
Just never trust electric. That's it. Never trust.
Never, dude. No, I don't like touching it at all, man. I just wanted to run a cable line. I am a TV guy. Like,
deadly
I run
spaghetti.
A cable guy and an eye to change the channels. And I'm not, I could do that. I cannot run fix this electrical wire.
No, electrical stuff is like not the things my forte. That
he's going to do to remedy this mess up is mind blowing to me. And he won't even like trip a breaker when he does it. He'll like do it He'll do it live.
See, that's crazy.
It's 110, right? It's 110.
That's what Dennis was saying, but I just still kill you.
110.
It won't kill you.
Well, 110 across your heart.
Maybe that would kill you.
Yeah, but like 110 getting in your finger.
It'll just suck. It'll make your teeth chatter.
Yeah.
It'll give you a little,
you know, like your arm will get all, you'll get like all weird.
Would it kill Dennis?
You'll get a tingly.
Although I was electrocuted once.
Dennis, get the 110.
Let's find out.
I was electrocuted once. But it was like, I don't know what they do. It was when you run I ran the Tough Mudder. At the end, they have these dangling.
Yeah, that's like that.
I remember ran through it and I was like.
Yeah, but that's not 110.
No, definitely not as much as that. But
That's like a 9-volt batter.
Whatever that was.
When you lick a 9-volt batter.
No, that was. Whatever that was, like, I was like running through. I was like, oh, I got this. And then the last few tentacles that were dangling just, and I just like my arms and I just fell.
You have no control.
Did not feel good.
Oh my God, he just pops in.
Wait, I thought we were shut down. What's he's got nothing to do.
I never shut down. I'm always on Twitter, on everything. What do you need?
I don't know. Like, you popped in. I didn't call for you.
I gotta tell you.
What, you been electrocuted recently?
I've never been electrocuted. Have you seen my hair? It's fantastic. I gotta tell you, though, this shutdown that happened, is it still happening? I don't know.
Well, yes. Who knows?
Because honestly, they're doing nothing. No one's doing anything. So what are we shutting down? No one ever does anything anyway.
POTUS, everybody.
I got it.
Oh, sorry. It's still here.
Stormy
it's
Daniels.
It's amazing, like, when the music stops, he immediately
he just vanishes.
He exits.
Stormy Daniels fake news.
Oh.
I don't even know what that means.
I think he was waiting to hear what her story would have been before he called it fake news or not. If no, Stormy's up there saying,
just kidding, I'm back. I banged her.
Yeah. Ow. President Trump was the greatest I've ever had. That's real news.
She signed an NDA. Don't worry about it. 130
tiny
grand.
Pizzas? Fake news. Did you read the whole thing?
130 no. grand later. No big deal.
Oh, it's amazing.
Oh, he was like laying on his. He was shirtless
he
on
ordered,
the bed.
He ordered.
Hold on
supposedly.
A second. Hold on a second. Just remember, this was before I became president. Okay.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Doesn't matter what I did. Bill Clinton was getting blowies while he was president. I am too, just by Melania, for most what you know.
Regardless of what side you're on, though, the hypocrisy is so awesome because all the people are like, it was before, it's fine, he's this, that, let him be. Why are we talking about his personal life? But meanwhile, when Clinton was, staining dresses, it's like, he was the worst human being in the world.
He
was the president.
With an intern.
Yes.
Just saying.
You got to read the, like, what supposedly happened, though, the transcripts of it.
The shark thing and everything?
It is the weirdest
thing. Like, him hating sharks and stuff?
That's kind of weird, but then there's, like, a whole thing about him ordering a big pizza with little pizzas on it or something. Because
what?
And he's like, I'm gonna give you the best pizza you ever had. It's going to have little pizzas on it. It's, like, really weird. It's
that
interesting.
Sounds delicious.
Pizza on
pizza
is probably
sound
good.
Pretty good.
I mean, now, I'm kind of there with him.
if
after all this, I'll tell you.
Take Twitter out of the equation.
Yeah.
Right? It doesn't exist. Right. Is he a good or a bad president?
I gotta go with bad still.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know. He's
the way he presents himself is so childish.
I mean,
like when he talks, he can't.
If it's 1975, and media is what it is in the 75. He goes down in history as the greatest president.
If it was 1865, he would have like,
you know what I mean? Like, I didn't vote for him and I don't love him. I think he's a pompous ass, but
right.
But like things are pretty good right now.
To me, I don't know if things are good.
Here's
big
the thing.
Companies are moving back into the country. Everybody's got money in their pocket.
Tron's down. I mean, first of all, let's.
No, down for you. It's three times up for me.
No, it's up. Tron's up.
One of the crazy things, though, honestly, like all it really is, like Fox News, CNN, all this, and the whole politics, like, and how everyone says one thing and then they say the other. It's just a big it's like wrestling drama on a whole new level.
Right.
Like, that's literally how I look at it.
The president's doing is kayfabe.
He is literally in the Wrestling Hall of Fame.
Because
it's perfect.
Well, no, the funny thing is, because if you go back and you watch like a speech by Chuck Schumer, he's saying stuff that Trump is saying now. Agreeing. If you go back and watch what Barack Obama said about immigration, it's the same thing that Trump. It's just, it's all.
Yeah, they're all the same.
It's like, I'm this and you're that. No, we're all people. Can we just be friendly and get along? Hey, like, that's what I'm saying.
You know what? They're all the same. We're drinking whiskey at 2 in the afternoon. Life is good.
Yeah, you're right. I don't know if that's Trump's fault, but
I'm saying that's a good thing.
I'll give it to him.
Speaking of politics, we all know Iran, right, for town council.
Yeah.
So the mayor.
You did not run in Iran, though. You ran here.
Tennessee and Tiger.
Yeah, I mean, like, what do you want me to do?
I wish you still filmed every episode because the look you just gave me of utter disgust.
It was terrible.
It was palpable.
The mayor of my wonderful town called me up and he commended me on a clean campaign, right? Mm-hmm. So, which I did. We all talked about this on past episodes.
I'm assuming the troll called right after.
Well, hold on. Okay, so they appointed me to two positions. I'm on the zoning board and I'm on the Environmental Shade Tree Commission, which is great.
It's awesome.
Like huge, right? Huge
win.
Yeah,
congrats.
So then I was like, I went, I got sworn in, I did my first meeting and everything, and then I opened up the Facebook. there he was.
Oh no. Man. Yeah, I got appointed to something too. Appointed to looking after the underneath my bridge. Make sure the moss is growing nice and full. Palano politics. Listen, I gotta tell you something. How many votes did you get? Like 300 something? Yeah, listen. Everyone loves me. I got hair that like sticks straight up. I was in a movie recently called Troll.
Wait, so you're like a Justin Timberlake troll?
Yeah.
Okay. Yep.
So
that checks out.
I go to the trolls. Facebook. I just had.
By the way, did you see what I posted when you were running? I literally, the thing I posted on Facebook was great. It was like a picture of you looking happy. And I was like, is this what you want? How great is that?
Do you want a happy person?
I had to just go check it out. And he says, that independent candidate, I knew he was working with the Democrats to keep us down. They appointed him to four positions.
I didn't say that.
What?
I know.
Because what positions would they appoint you to? I'm the ones in charge of the bridges in Neptune.
He's not a. No.
You know that bridge by Corley's Ave? That's where I live.
And the other guy that I ran against, the Republican, he's nowhere. They deleted his Facebook page. So,
he's gone.
Anyway, I just wanted to give a little political update.
It seems like you're still involved, which is good.
I am very much so involved.
So you actually cared. The other ones were trying to do it for the glory, trying to maybe do it for some, you know.
They sent Mike like a...
for the ladies.
It literally is a foot thick paperwork to read.
Well, you know, it's part of the job now, right? Really.
Yeah.
You mean the civil the public service.
You mean I got to read stuff?
I know, man. It's great because they did send me. It was literally. It's right there.
Yeah.
That stack of papers.
Oh my god.
And there's a note on it. I got it on like a Tuesday. They're like, please read this by Thursday for the meeting. Okay.
You know what you do? This is what I did in college.
Then I cut a line.
They would say like you read pages 5 through 110.
Yeah.
You read somewhere in the middle. Read like 5 pages. And then
you read page 1 and the last page.
Or you could do that, or just read like. A chunk in the middle.
Yeah.
For any of you college students listening, this is golden. And then right when you get to class, you know, and the teacher starts saying, so what'd you guys think of the raise your hand right away. Well, you know, there was the one part where I didn't really agree with, the woman, she was the suffrage because
it's actually quite brilliant.
Everyone just wanted to
And if you could reference that page number, you're golden.
But oh, yeah. You're like, it was, I don't know. I think it was like chapter 4, page 55, I guess.
I just muted his mic. I really wanted to hear the end of your story, and he just keeps trying to interrupt you.
But that's a good idea for you.
Very...
I did it in college. But where it could backfire sometimes is if they come back to you. They're like,
that's when you go, I didn't understand that part.
No, or you could just, you know, kind of improv your way out of it.
Right.
And remember, listen to what the other kids are saying. What the other students are saying, don't just tune them out when they, and then you could, there's always ways around.
You got to listen.
If you guys could just go back in the podcast for a little bit, you'll hear Derek actually say with his own words, I don't agree with women's suffrage.
Hey, what's up? This is Derek D. I didn't really agree with women's suffrage.
Which is women's right to vote.
Did he say that?
He just said it. It's like, I don't agree with women's suffrage.
Oh, wow.
Hey, what's up? This is Derek D. I didn't really agree with women's suffrage. I wasn't talking about me. I'm just talking about it could...
Isolate
Derek.
I don't agree with women's suffrage.
Hey, what's up? This is Derek D. I didn't really agree with women's suffrage.
My friend in I think it was senior year.
I was just saying something that could have been written in a book at some point.
You said it. I mean,
I don't believe that at all.
You might not believe it.
It's isolated.
Now, it's isolated.
That's how this podcast is going to start, actually.
Oh, I don't agree with women's suffrage.
No, did I say something like, I don't believe how women's suffrage?
Well, it really doesn't matter because I'm going to cut it to say what I wanted to say.
Hey, what's up? This is Derek D. I didn't really agree with women's suffrage. Jeez.
Derek, what did you not say?
Hey, what's up? This is Derek D. I didn't really agree with women's suffrage.
I had a friend, and I think it was senior year. We'd do book reports. It was like you had to read a book. It's summer reading or whatever.
Sure.
So you come back September, and there it is. There's your summer reading. And she was like, my teacher's like, what'd you read? And he was like, having not read anything, he's like, I read the book Jaws.
Mm.
And she was like, you did? You read Jaws, the book? And he's like, yep. And she's like, who was that by? And he goes, oh, I can't remember the author, because he obviously didn't read Peter Benchley's Jaws.
Mm-hmm.
He just had seen the movie, obviously. Yeah. And she goes, well...
it would have been money if you had the author's
She goes,
name.
All right, well, is it similar to the movie? And he goes, they made a movie out of that?
And I was like,
that's
nice.
Wow. That's amazing.
Next level.
She couldn't fight him. I don't know.
They made a movie out of that.
It was tough.
Oh, so good. So good.
That's a solid comeback.
Yeah.
Then what'd you say?
I think I was electrocuted.
F?
You're in hell. This is hell.
You didn't think I was going to be here, did you?
You didn't know. But here we are. PBR
this
forever.
This can't be life.
Who would have thought?
This can't be it.
You created this, and now it's going to be your eternity.
You created a bearded tailor.
This is a never-ending bottle of Jameson.
With a drill
well,
on
that
the
wouldn't,
table.
There wouldn't be that in hell.
Oh, no. It would be a never-ending bottle of Zima or just like a never-ending bottle of like punch.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Ooh.
That came in abruptly.
It did.
I'm okay with it.
I like it when it suggests itself.
I'm okay with it.
It's good to be back in the studio.
It feels great.
Yeah, it's good
this
to be back.
This is 2018. This is our first show in-house.
I like having headphones on when you're podcasting.
Yeah, you don't wear them on your show.
I don't have any. We don't have any.
Well, you don't play music.
We'll get
some.
You
still put the cheering noise in the background?
It's much lower now. Okay. We took the echo out.
Oh,
we changed things up a little.
New Jersey 101.5.
Yeah, we
got made fun of.
It was
once,
after the 50th.
And we removed that.
Yeah, I didn't even realize we had it on for like.
He said
years.
One thing to me about it, and I was like, "All right, yeah, that's." I was always like on the fence about it. Anyway, that was it.
That's how it happened with us.
Yeah, somebody teased us, you know, and rather than stand up to a bully,
we caved.
We caved.
What was it you said before?
Hey, what's up? This is Derek D. I didn't really agree with women suffrage. Where was what I said? What did
about
I say
about the women?
I didn't say anything. I love women. I said so. I was as if you read a book and you had something in there that you didn't enjoy. Shut up.
You hear that music. If it's the first time you're listening to us ever, I don't know why you would be at this point, right? But this is a game we call Top or Bottom.
But we welcome new listeners.
We do welcome new listeners. I'm going to give you two terms. Which one's on top, which one's on the bottom. We'll round table it. Top or bottom, Taylor Allen, 2017 or 2018?
Oh boy, man, gotta go with 2000. Well, all right, I'm gonna go with 2018 on top because we don't know what's gonna happen.
It's very
could
new,
be great, and also you're gonna have a baby in 2018.
I think I've died in 2018.
You might have died. So again, 2018 on top. It's a crazy year.
You know what I mean?
It's nuts.
Yeah. A lot going on. I've had some good. So far, I did a couple good shows. There's some fun podcasts. So I'm digging 2018.
Okay,
I'm liking it.
I'm gonna put 2018 on top. It hasn't been great for Dennis, but you know, like, just so much year left to just pull it out. You know?
Yeah.
Get out of the well. Get things right.
This is the year I'm getting out of the well.
You know? Yeah. Get out. Maybe I'll get into a shed.
Good.
We can put them in the shed.
Yeah, oh, man.
Shed. I actually been thinking about turning the shed into my studio, into our studio.
Is it big enough?
I mean, it's about, it's 10 by 10. I mean, what are we sitting in right now?
Yeah. Like, my garage is like 10 by 10, so you'd be good to go.
But like to a foot behind you, how to the wall, how big is that? That's probably 10 by 10.
Yeah.
Dennis, get a tape measure.
Coming up.
You know what? I thought about this since you said it. I think I'm going 2017 on top because the majority of 2017, the first three quarters were good. I got a lot of good gigs, my one-man show, all that stuff. The end of 2017 sucked a bag of D's. And 2018 so far has sucked a bag of D's, but I haven't gone into it fully yet. So I'm going to go 2017 on top because the majority of it was better than 2018 so far. So there you go.
Averages. I think if you put 2017 on top, you're just giving up. You got to put 2018 on top.
I don't. Explanation. I'm looking forward. hasn't happened yet, though.
I'm looking forward to 2018. Only Chalupa Batman will be here.
Chalupa.
We'll see, obviously.
I'm excited
you're in
about
for
that.
It, buddy.
Yeah?
Oh, man. I can't wait for you to explain.
Yeah, but you you have a girl. He's having a dude. Maybe that's a difference.
Yeah, but babies, I feel like are babies.
Similar. Yeah. Yeah. I feel like they shit girl. All over the place. Yeah, that's
Do you
true.
Not like being a dad?
I love it. It's the best thing in the world.
So what's
it's
with the
good
rib?
To turn everybody? Your brain into an insane... I can't explain it. It's great. It is great, but I'm an insane person now. There's a big part of me that is, I lost, you know? But I gained a lot in my heart.
This sounds terrible.
It's good.
Everybody I talk to, dude, they all act like this.
You're going to need to get more.
They're like, oh, it's the greatest thing in the world, but it sucks.
Yeah,
it
is. Like, that's pretty much what everyone says.
You're like fully consumed with love and affection, and it honestly, it's going to change your life. It's going to be incredible, and you're also going to lose... your mind, and it's gonna be—it's fun.
Honestly,
it's fun. It's
why
a fun
do you
ride.
Keep but saying no, that?
This doesn't happen. Remember your parents.
Obviously, I don't have any kids, so I can't speak specifically on the matter. But what he's saying is 100%.
Why'd you say it like a 1987s rap star?
I did.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, I don't know.
Like you were just like, I can't speak.
That was awesome.
I don't know if it's 87 or just like Eminem style. But anyway. When you think about your friends, don't say any names, that have like multiple kids and you're like, how the hell did they? And they have multiple, like three, mm-hmm. and they're all like between the ages of like 6 and 3, mm-hmm. and they're doing it. Then you feel better about yourself. Like, I could do one. I could do one right now.
You guys all commented on my beard when I walked in. I didn't even realize I hadn't shaved. That's where I'm at.
Really?
I knew.
Is it that hard?
It's very intense.
You get that poop
There's
finger?
A lot of ups and downs. Poop. I have found pieces of poo in places that they couldn't have possibly been.
Are you uncomfortable with that drill right there? Do you want it moved?
It's just
You can put it on the floor, right, man. Here. Like, it's right in your face.
My cousin Mike just had a baby. And if you follow me on any of my social media, you definitely saw he visited. She's chubby, cherubic, awesome little kid. But he's like, the diarrhea constantly. Just at the beginning, it's like splattered straight up the back. Up the back.
The poo, it's there, but it's not like the worst
thing.
Well,
she's only 8 months, but she's
What's
fat
the worst
as
thing?
You get, the worst thing is, for me, was like the not sleeping. Like, that was a big thing.
You don't sleep at all?
Well, now you're probably better, right? No?
Sometimes, but like,
how old's your daughter?
She's 3.
3.
So she'll still wake up, but like, just when they get sick, they're sick all the time. It's a whole thing.
Why are they sick all the time?
Because they're just kids. They're just sick.
They get shots and shit?
Because they walk through the mall and then they'll run their hand on the floor and lick it. And you're like, oh, what? You're like,
that makes them stronger.
It does ultimately, but in
the time. Can you imagine if we do that? Like, get there. run our hand on the floor of the mall and lick it and be like, what? My kid did it.
Right.
Oh, man. Casey Jones tells a story about a kid on the subway in New York City who was like sitting on the floor and he like licked the floor.
Come on.
And he's like, oh my God, I just witnessed this kid get AIDS.
every disease. He got everything. Yeah. He got it all.
Here comes super herpes.
But all the crazy stuff is outweighed by, it really is. It's like so cliche to say, but you're so obsessed with the kid that it's like, all right, well.
Well, I'm excited about it.
It is. It's all right. Great.
So I don't care what you say.
No, it's
Chalupa,
great.
Batman,
I'm
and myself.
I'm excited for Chalupa, Batman.
Are going to have a good time. And I'm going to be, we're going to have this baby in April, and then I'm out of school, and I'm going to like just chill all summer with my dude.
Can I announce like a little maybe conspiracy theory here? So he keeps saying Chalupa, Batman. I feel like the kid's initials are going to be CBP.
CB. Yes.
CBP somehow.
What the, how do you get a P out of Chalupa Batman?
P is Polano.
Oh, my left hand.
C, like Chris. B,
no,
for
you did
like.
Not just do that.
No, I thought like I didn't know where he was going.
Like Christopher Brian Polano.
Are
or
we
something.
Doing like a pool, some sort of a pool?
I would like to do a pool because I really don't know what I actually know what I want to name.
Well, you know, it's a boy.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So
but
Chalupa
I'm saying,
Batman
like Wayne stuff.
Calogero Berlusconi Polano.
I think him and the lovely and talented keep saying Chalupa Batman because it's like a C and a B. I don't know. That's just my thinking. Probably not right at all, but. It's my hypothesis.
It's actually not right at all. We're just big fans of the
Charlie
league.
Brown Polano.
Yeah, that's where I thought it came
the
from.
The league, man.
Charlie Brown.
Yeah. But they did name him like Christopher Bryan.
No, his name was Chalupa Batman.
Well, yeah, because he lost. Because
he got rights. Right. He got naming rights.
Naming rights to his kid.
And they play the song in the delivery
room. That show was so good. What was the
Forever
was
the league? The league. I can't believe
what was the trophy's name?
It was on FX.
Oh,
right?
It
was
the Shiva.
The Shiva. The Shiva, he's like screams her name
Shiva
outside.
Shiva, like, Chabra, Chabra, fun! Are we still playing Top or Bottom?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm 2018 inside me.
On top. Top or Bottom number two, OK Google or Alexa?
Neither.
I don't know what OK Google is, to be honest with
it's
you.
It's the same thing as Alexa, but for Google.
I just got a little, you know, what is it? The thing? The Amazon thing? What's it called?
Fire Stick
Alexa.
Oh, the Echo.
I got the Echo for Christmas, and I like it a lot. Except for there's a song called Raining Tacos that my daughter is obsessed with. And every single time I'm like, hey, Alexa, play Miles Davis or something. She'll be like, Alexa, play Raining Tacos. Like right as every time I put something on. So it's constant Raining Tacos. But I'll still go Alexa on top.
One of the other reasons why it's great having a kid.
Yeah, it's fun. It is funny. It's constantly funny.
I don't have an OK Google. I have an Alexa down in the well. And I don't really quite know what I'm supposed to do with it. Yeah, I got all kinds of construction down there.
You could, it's just like Siri.
Yeah, all right. So I'm going to put Alexa on top, but I'm not 100% on it.
I don't have either. I've messed around with both. That sounds weird.
You messed around with Alexa?
Alexa and OK. That's weird. But I don't know. OK Google, I was at my buddy's house the other day during the games, and we were, we played like, I said, OK Google, play Adam Sandler at a medium pace, and it did it right away, so that was kind of cool.
Great. I totally forgot about that song.
Yeah.
That song
went right to it. I feel like Alexa would be like, what? Are you sure you want me to play that?
The shampoo bottle gets me every damn time.
I heard that there was like a thing with Alexa where people were, like kids were saying like, Alexa, order Nintendo Switch, and then Alexa
yeah.
would be like, ordering Nintendo Switch from
yeah, their
Amazon.
Parents
and
account.
It would just happen. Yeah.
Yeah.
So like that's kind of scary, but.
And the one thing where Alexa like witnessed a murder and helped, like I don't know, like what's going on.
Big it's Black Mirror.
Yeah.
Do you watch? All right.
I don't, but I need to. And by the way, I watched
see
the Punisher.
Yeah,
is
watch
awesome.
It all.
You're welcome.
The Punisher is awesome.
Punisher's amazing.
Oh,
you're so good. You're welcome.
My only thing is though, like he gets shot so many times, but he's like, always
oh, where he gets shot.
No, I know. But anyway, it's great.
No, there is no one only thing when it comes to the Punisher. That was amazing.
Do you guys know him somehow?
We
want to know him.
He follows some of our social media.
I know he follows PBR.
Yeah.
Because I remember one time when like the first time I was ever on PBR, he liked the picture, and I was like, oh my god.
Yeah. We tried to get him onto this.
Does he still follow us?
I don't know, but I don't peruse our social media
crazy.
Like that.
That guy was on Howard, and it was
he's
the most
great.
Awesome interview. I was like, I want to hang out.
Great.
That was
yeah.
also
he's got a history. He was a bad boy.
That
yeah.
was also prior to him being a celebrity, so he was
yeah,
probably
right.
well. No, he was probably
he was
on Walking
Dead.
Dead.
Maybe
that's
just,
where I knew him from.
Maybe just
yeah,
on Walking
I think
Dead.
He was probably like
because I think
two.
We probably started the show. Prior, or like just around the same time Walking Dead started.
Billy Russo.
He was great, man. He was in Fury. Yeah. That movie was awesome. Fury.
Billy Russo.
OK Google on top. And I'll tell you what to do with. I'm going to tell you guys right now what to do with your devices if you have them. And yeah. everything that you're saying is true. Yes, they listen to everything you say. They will order your Nintendo Switch. Mm-hmm. They will solve murders. Yeah. I put mine in my kitchen. And it is paramount for cooking.
Yeah,
that's a good idea.
That's where it is in my buddy's house.
Timer
and his wife.
Okay, Google, set a timer for 5 minutes. Okay, setting a timer for 5 minutes.
That is
right. Okay, Google, play some music. Turn it up. Turn it down. I got stuff on my hands. Right? I was like, Pam, how? Like, what should the temperature of this chicken be, and how long do I cook it? Okay, Google, how long do I cook a 4-pound chicken for, and what should the temperature be?
Yeah,
right.
Genius.
Like, yeah. It changes cooking, especially for someone
genius.
Who doesn't know how to cook.
Yeah, yeah.
I love it, dude. I got it for Christmas. I got it in like a Santa grab bag. Like,
is it the one that's like round?
I got it luckily. Oh. It was like one of those things everybody puts a gift in and
yeah.
then you can steal it.
Yeah.
And I
White
was
Elf.
Like,
White Elf.
Yeah.
White Elf Yankee Swap.
I was like, mm-hmm. I'll take this thing and I love it, dude. I ordered another one.
For where?
You
only have one kitchen.
Well, you
can
sync
them up. So if there's one down here, you could be like, you not only stereo, but you could use it as a conference. So if Pam's down here and I'm upstairs, you could talk through it.
How amazing.
Oh, right?
How amazing.
What?
Yeah. Okay, Google.
Oh, man.
I said okay, Google on topic.
I might switch mine, to be honest.
Science.
Nintendo Switch it, yeah.
I got.
Okay,
I got
that's enough.
Switch.
You got
I don't
one.
Want to get started with that.
See, John Bernthal, this is what you're getting.
Yeah. Knee deep
in Zelda. Yeah, if you're listening, John Bernthal, please come on the show.
If you're listening, John Bernthal, and you got any Zelda tips, send them our way.
Dear John Bernthal.
Did anyone see Baby Driver?
Yes.
No, I heard it's good.
No, but I heard it's good.
John's
absolutely
in that as well.
Absolutely loved it. He is in that, and that movie is so good.
It yeah, I heard it's is good.
One of the best movies I've seen in a while.
I'm not going to disagree with you, but I have a hard time saying best movie. It is one of the most creative and new, it is different. The new musical.
Is yeah. that it's Edgar Wright, isn't it?
Yes.
Oh, I love
it. Yeah. Right? Would yes. you it's yeah, a musical.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I wonder if
sick.
I wonder if that actor, I forget his name, learned a bunch of that actually those driving skills are like that was all stunt. I wonder if he
The driving is awesome, but the yeah. like you forget said, about the driving, the put dude. There are it's genius.
There are shots of him. First of all, it's a musical. So there's always music. The gunshots are to the music. Everything is to the music.
Yeah.
And he there are a number of shots in the movie, at least two I could think of, that are like over 2 or 3 minutes long that are one shot.
Oh, yeah, those are great.
And that go through the whole town.
Like the, like the Goodfellas shot.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen True Detective?
Yeah. That's the whole show.
Yeah.
That episode.
The
oh
whole
my God.
Show, dude.
Insane.
It's insane.
Or like True Detective did a one
shot. What was the movie with episode? Michael it's Keaton?
It's one like shot majority. Entire. No, not the it's majority. The whole it's the entire episode. It's one shot.
What's
the
movie? Is it McConaughey? Because I didn't watch the other one.
Oh, it's.
It's the first one.
That's the only one, really. What about what was that movie with Michael Keaton? Birdman?
Yes.
Birdman.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
There was.
They made it look like.
They made it look like right. it. There were some like swipes where like they right. went behind a door. And
but I think they did a lot of that.
They did a lot of yeah.
Snake Eyes with De Palma and
yes, Nicolas Cage.
Yeah, that's like a 10-minute one shot.
Goodfellas crazy. Has a good
crazy.
One.
And
imagine you get 9 minutes into the thing and Nicolas Cage like.
You just gotta go with
back
it.
Back to
man.
One.
No, you just gotta go with it.
See, the cool thing about that is like you have to rehearse like theater for that
yeah.
because it's got to be all timed out and so like if you don't know your lines.
It's gotta hit those marks.
What are you doing that? What? This is good stuff.
No, I'm kidding.
This is what you're getting, John Bernthal.
I'm kidding.
Dear John Bernthal.
John Bernthal's like, yeah, that's all true.
That's what he's
I
talking
love
about.
This podcast.
Yeah, so if you haven't seen The Punisher, definitely can watch it.
So good.
So good.
So
I made my mom it. Watch it. I watched 3 episodes with her and she's now hooked, but it's so good.
One of the best lines that he ever said was it was in Daredevil when they're at the diner and he's talking to the reporter. I didn't remember.
Karen.
He's talking to Karen, and he looks out the window. She's like, "What?" He's like, "No, just seen about two guys about to walk into the last diner they'll ever ruin their entire life." And I'm like, "Oh my God!"
So like smart and clever with
have
stuff.
You, now I don't like Daredevil, so I stopped watching it. However, I
watched all Daredevil.
I YouTube. Oh, so you saw it? Yeah. Have you?
No, I haven't.
All right,
seen
so Daredevil. I YouTubed because I'm such a fan of the Punisher. I YouTubed his scenes. You should do that.
They're so good.
New Daredevil or like
he was in the
I
first
didn't even
season.
Mind the Affleck.
Okay.
Daredevil on Netflix. I thought was good. A little slow in the beginning, but I thought it was good. William Dafoe.
So how?
Who played?
I didn't watch it.
Who played Kingpin?
Oh, Vincent D'Onofrio.
Vincent D'Onofrio.
Oh, yeah.
How many episodes does the Punisher actually show up in?
He's in a lot in the second season.
So Google it, dude.
I'll probably watch it.
There's one or two where he's in jail that are pretty sick.
Dude. Yeah.
He's great.
Oh, man, it's good.
He's dude, good.
It's
good.
Top or bottom, number 3, Trump or Oprah?
You could be a senator, and you could be a senator. We're all going to be senators.
Why do they all have to be reality people?
Yeah.
I'll go Oprah. I don't know.
Why not, right?
Yeah.
I mean, why not?
Shake it up. Oprah's on top. Yeah. I mean,
who does she run with?
Stedman.
Jerry Springer?
Yeah, seriously.
Let's bring back Sally Donahue. Jesse Raphael.
Donahue.
Love it.
Donahue. How about, what's his name?
I bet she runs with Obama's wife.
I don't think she's going to run.
She's gonna run?
She'd be
I think
stupid.
Or The Rock. He was going to run, too.
Yeah, but he wants to be a Republican.
I do love The Rock, but like... I just, why do we need celebrities? Let's just get.
We
the,
don't.
Let's get Mike Pilano back in there.
Yeah.
Let's get like just someone guy we never heard of that's like decorated
good
military guy and he's smart. Like, yeah.
Did you answer?
I did not yet. You know what? Whatever. I'm going to put Oprah on top. I mean, at this point, what did I say before we started? The United States has become high school. So we're all just going to vote who we think is great, you know, who we're popular and want to be friends with. So Oprah, we'll put Oprah on the top.
Man, this is just Dave.
She'll sit down with Putin.
She's so Hollywood now, and like the whole like everyone's like, oh, let's do this, and then there's a million pictures of them with Harvey Weinstein, and everyone says they knew and all this stuff. It's like, come on, I don't want. He's already the president, so I guess him on top, but neither.
Yeah, I don't
You're voting
know.
For anarchy?
I'll put Oprah on top, whatever. I don't care. It doesn't really affect me. Like,
he wrote the questions.
I'd put Leslie Jones on. Black woman. I'd put Leslie Jones up there before Oprah.
The government shut down, right? Like, yeah, it affected me none. I still almost burned my house down.
It did. There would have been no firemen to come help you.
Nothing.
I said what I said before. I tweeted before. Are we in the purge type of a situation? That's or is it more Mad Max?
Leather.
I have to know how to shop. That's all.
Who sings Killing in the Name of, that old rock band?
I'm trying to think what you're trying to put together here.
Killing in the Name.
Rage Against the Machine, but what do you need me to say?
Top or bottom number four, women's suffrage. For or against?
But I'm trying to get like what he's...
Women's suffrage?
For or against? What was the name of that band?
Rage for the Machine.
He already said it.
He already did say it. So you can't change it now. Yeah. It's not like I can't not go back and edit that first time to say it. Well, maybe if I say it again the other way, he won't be able to isolate that.
Well, you know what? You didn't say it before.
But you did.
I didn't know what you were getting at.
But I did. and everybody will.
Are we? Oh, this is an actual idea. I was trying to get him to say it. You got to be for the women.
Yes.
You're top. On the women's side. Yes. Top.
Come on.
Women voting on top, of course.
I was talking about an old book from someone that read in a class that was probably for like...
A paper that he wrote.
I
was talking about an old book that I wrote. I hated women.
Oh, my goodness.
And you're listening to PBR.
You're listening to PBR podcast. You see, John, this is what you get, John.
Do you want me to just say it? Because if you're going to do it anyway.
No, it's definitely more fun. Like when I edited Ladondo saying, a card carrying member of the Communist Party.
That was really funny. Yeah, that was good. That was great.
Hey, what's up? This is Derek D. Didn't really agree with woman suffrage.
Top or bottom, last one. Super Bowl or World Series?
All right, so here's the thing for me. Mm-hmm. Little weird. I'm gonna go Super Bowl on top. I am much more of a baseball fan. World Series, I feel like it's if your team isn't in it, and I love baseball, but it's seven games. It could be seven games. It's a long series. Yeah. Super Bowl is one big event. It's a whole thing. There's a lot of fanfare. There's a halftime show. It's a fun night, and I never care who's in the Super Bowl, so I'm like, all right, I'm always having a good time. Super Bowl on top for me.
I'm going to agree with everything that you just said. Super Bowl on top, because what, are you going to have seven parties in a row?
And I mean, yeah, but...
who's going to be excited by the time you get to game six?
Right.
Yeah, I think that Super Bowl definitely on top.
Yeah, I mean, I love baseball. I love playing it growing up, but watching, you know, seven games, especially like, because they go back and forth between their own, you know, their home stadium, the other stadium, and then sometimes you can win... like at the away stadium, and it's kind of like, like at least Super Bowl, it's usually neutral, but although it might not be this year,
that'd
Vikes.
Be insane.
You know, so obviously Super Bowl on top. I want to see the Vikings.
Super Bowl is clearly on top, right? But I wouldn't hate a 3-game series.
Me either.
That's what
I think it would get more eyes.
And like Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
Wow. Yes, that's it.
You got 52 men on the roster.
That's it.
Use them. You know what I mean? Like, football's the only
Are you
sport
talking about a three-game series for football or a three-game series for baseball?
No, for football.
Oh, wow. I think I would like it better for baseball, too. But
say both, yeah.
You don't utilize your roster
but
in
your
NFL.
Body. Well,
no, I don't. Dude, don't give me that, because NHL players go do as...
No, but here's the thing.
More contact, as a matter of fact. At higher rates of speed with less padding, and they play 3-4 times a week.
Yeah, and it's different.
Why?
It's just different.
Why is it different?
Because it's like, we won this game, or we won these first two, but then our quarterback went down, so you got this backup guy. Like, no one...
What if your goalie gets hurt, or your star center gets hurt?
Dude, look what happens in a game that doesn't mean nothing. They put in backups and stuff. So it's like, no one's really interested in that.
But it makes some interesting coaching.
No,
like,
yeah. It's,
you
dude,
start
I disagree
your starter
with you
on
immensely.
Game one?
Yeah, exactly. You use those 52 men.
The logic makes sense, but I think
I think people give football players, for some reason, like it's not the most physically taxing sport out there. Not even remotely.
Yes, remote. Very, very
no, it's
remotely.
Not. Some dudes.
It's probably very similar to hockey because
some dudes
the hitting
hit every
and everything.
Play. Some dudes don't even get touched all game long.
Well, yeah, kickers.
You know what's crazy?
No, receivers, cornerbacks.
Yeah, receivers get destroyed. What?
The whole
receivers?
The whole game.
Dude, receivers are
just
the
running.
But hold on.
Soccer guys are running.
Yeah, but that's not mainly. It's not I'm putting it in quotes.
It's a lot of cardio.
Quotes. But you got to think, dude. Like, receivers are getting lit.
Not anymore.
Not
every
play.
And I would contend that that's the reason that Minnesota's moving on in the playoffs, because receivers don't get lit up anymore. And that cornerback
that
on the Saints
insane.
Didn't want to get a flag, so he didn't hit him at the end of the game, and he lost the game before.
He basically it almost looked like he was a little scared and put his sight on the back burner and just kind of leaped. He still leaped, but like the other guy kind of moved.
Telling you, man.
Do you think any money went into any pockets with that play?
No, I think he was terrified that if I hit this guy.
Yeah, I think you're right.
If I make a play on the ball and he gets a penalty and I get a penalty. Well, let me finish my thought. If I make a play on the ball and I get a pass interference, they kick an easy field goal. If I hit him too hard, I get a penalty, they get an easy field goal. Right. So what am I going to do? All he had to do was hold it.
Right.
He was way behind him.
He missed by a lot.
He didn't have to dive at him.
That was crazy.
The time was expired. All he had to do was wrap him up and hold him, and the game's over.
Right.
But so he does. He has a brain fart. It expires during the play. So he has a brain fart.
No.
Yes.
No.
It expires.
If he got hit, he would have stepped out of bounds.
It expires during the play. The clock. Maybe.
If he got hit, he definitely would have been out. There was no way he would have not been out.
You're making an assumption.
So are you.
No, I'm not.
You're saying that he was afraid to hit. I've seen that play a million times. It looked like he was kind of
the mom and dad fight.
I'm not fighting. I'm just saying, like, the NFL is over.
Where's the drill?
It's dying. It's the worst. It also has the worst ratings it's ever had, almost in the history of the NFL. And it's just getting worse and worse and worse. And every time something like that happens, it just cuts it down even more. Like, nobody's watching.
He's right. There's another side of that, though, that it is the worst ratings, but the ratings are still super high compared to other sports.
Yeah. Right now, there, but it's on the decline.
I think it's dying at the root, though. I think a lot of parents don't want to put their kids in football because of all the
concussions. 100% agree with you on that.
So now, like, the talent isn't going to be there eventually.
Look at this. I've obviously been a fan my whole life. My whole life. I have Troy Aikman hanging on the wall right here behind me.
Yes. Literally, right? Troy Aikman. He's hanging on your wall. Sorry. It's been very uncomfortable. Sorry, Troy.
Dennis, get him a drink. My son will never play football, tackle football,
yeah.
ever.
Yeah, but look at it like, you know, it will advance. Helmets will be better. I
couldn't disagree with that more.
National Flag Football League.
There's actually a football league, the AFL, that's actually taking its no pads, its full contact, and it's on the rise, and it's nobody gets hurt.
I wonder if they look at like rugby statistics.
Everybody takes it easy. Everybody,
yeah, it's like rugby. Dude.
But
like,
look at those statistics. So I bet you there's still a lot of guys with bad concussions.
Let's go to Andy Barr.
Ching. First fact check of the year.
He sent me a bunch of rugby stuff because he was like, "You should talk about rugby on your podcast because we talk about sports." And I started watching some of it, and it is insane.
Like, it's insane. Some guys wear almost leathery helmets,
and some guys wear nothing.
You got to get away.
Like, headbutt each other.
You got to get away from those helmets, dude. I'm serious. You have to get away from. You need less pads.
But
the
moment
NFL.
Two heads fast connect,
you won't
and crack a skull.
You won't. They won't do that.
Well, it's not happening in rugby.
Come on.
They won't do it.
It was a different sport.
No, they just
scrums and stuff. I'm not saying rugby.
There are wide open hits in rugby, dude, but they don't go head first because they don't have a helmet on. You physically won't do it. I'm telling you.
It's just your body is, right. If you have a helmet on, you're more likely. Like, if you have more padding, you're like, oh, whatever.
Dude, we all play tackle football as kids in the park. Like,
true.
You don't go that fast at each other.
But I think there's a whole other, just like there's problems now, there'll be a whole more problems. It's football. It's the game. It's a violent sport. Hockey, violent sport. It's what it is. Guys are getting their guys' throat slit because you ride on a blade.
Yeah.
You know, and he almost died.
That was crazy.
that's the exception. That's not the rule. I mean, there was one goalie who got skated over.
No, there's
every
sport, there's
exceptions,
exception.
Too. There's people that got paralyzed and stuff like that.
Well, every exception.
Doesn't happen all the time.
But you can't.
There are ways to make it safer, and there's ways to not destroy the game. The NFL, in my opinion, is destroying the game, and I think it's turning people off.
Yeah. Do you think are other ratings for other shows down as well, though? Because
I think ratings across the board are down. My brother-in-law sells advertising for the Olympics, and they're having a terrible time getting advertisers because people don't watch television
the
way we did.
The way they used to. It's
more on-demand stuff.
Kids. They do not watch the cable box, and if they do, it's DVR'd. I would argue that almost nothing is watched except for live. Nobody's watching. No one's sitting down at the TV at 7 o'clock to watch the Muppet Show on Thursday night with their brothers and sisters anymore. No.
This Is Us.
This Is Us takes place in the 80s, dude, with the flashbacks.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And that's when we did it. But that's gone. That's gone.
You're right.
Your daughter, my DVR. Son, they will never know the TV like that.
No, not the way we knew it.
It's on demand. So how do you sell advertising for that? That's really
the thing is they put most of the money still to the old school.
Like, kids will never know the heartbreak of missing, like, you know, Charlie Brown Christmas.
Yeah, like, oh, we missed it.
But
or the Grinch.
Like you said, like sports is the only thing left that you can watch live, and it's just as exciting as, like, because there, like you said, you DVR everything else.
DVR
and
a football game is just not as good.
Like we've talked about it on my podcast. Like, we watch games like the day after they happen. He's like, this is so stupid.
Yeah,
like, this,
yeah,
I already know where this goes, and
there's no way to get around it, because you'll see a post, you'll see something.
Right,
but even that is getting a little more on demand, because now you have like the NFL Red Zone channel.
Sure,
which you, when you first watch, you don't like.
And then
you start, like, 20 minutes later, you're like, this is the greatest.
Well, you need two TVs.
Yeah.
You want the game on that, you're like, your team, and then you want Red Zone and another.
So even news, like, when you want news, what do you go to? Like, the first thing I do is I look at my phone. Like,
absolutely.
I go to social media for it. And you know, I think it's T-Mobile, dude. Fact check it.
Well, Mops Chang.
So the NFL just signed a deal. So they're well aware of their ratings declining on television. So they're trying to figure out a way to reach the new generation of people. And I think they signed a deal with T-Mobile to make all of their games streamable to the phone.
Yahoo as well.
Okay.
So, you can watch games on Yahoo.
So they're that shows you right there that they're even moving away from the television.
Yeah.
And as it gets better, dude, I got to be honest, like, I don't want to go to the game. I want to watch it in my living room.
Uh-huh. Yeah. It's a crazy thing. Last weekend, I was at my aunt's house, a bunch of family. I told my cousin was here from LA, and the Eagles game was on, right? Eagles, Saints. Right?
No, it was Saints Vikings.
Yeah.
Saints,
right. Vikings. Eagles.
Steelers.
No. That's AFC.
No.
I was tied up. I didn't watch.
I don't remember.
Anyway, I'm drawing.
Patriots.
I'm drawing a blank. No, it wasn't the Patriots.
Dallas Cowboys.
I know it was. I'm just drawing a blank. That's not
the
point.
It was the Kansas City Chiefs.
No, it was not the Chiefs.
The Eagles.
Oh, the Montreal Expos.
Yes.
Yes.
The Eagles beat the Falcons. Okay.
The Falcons.
So, the Dirty Bird. He's right. He's right.
So anyway, no.
It was
the
Birds.
It was the
Cardinals were playing too.
There's the Cardinals.
The Orioles.
It doesn't matter. No one listening cares about this. We just lost everybody.
The Pigeons are new.
We lost them all.
Atlantic City.
Everyone's gone.
Forget about pigeons, the Seagulls.
Seahawks, I never forgot about the Seahawks. I've been a Seagulls fan.
Yeah, all these birds.
Everyone's gone.
You know?
Anyway, we saw the lights flicker. The lights flickered in the house. We go outside, we see a transformer blowing up. The power goes out of my aunt's house. And I was looking on my phone to get the game, and I had to pay for it, whatever. I haven't been on Periscope in probably a year. Went on Periscope. Somebody had their phone set up, aimed at the TV. We watched the last, from, like, the last 5 minutes of the game.
Yeah.
Me, my cousin, my brother, with just my phone on in the dark, watching it. And we watched
how I watch all UFC events.
Yeah.
On Periscope.
It was so awesome.
Yeah.
I mean, it wasn't the greatest, like, quality, but I was watching the game
live.
People
will put a little note on the UFC events. They'll write a hand note that says, do not heart this. And they put it on a tripod and they film the TV
because
hearts bring attention the power.
Yeah.
IRS gets,
Yeah, man, right? So how great is that?
Dan White was the guy.
Do you think, like, it'll eventually turn into where TV becomes more, like, I've been noticing, especially on, like, True TV specifically.